Greetings and welcome to Guilford County Schools training video. This video will help you navigate the PowerSchool Parent Portal for Guilford County Schools. The PowerSchool Parent Portal is a web-based application where parents can view student attendance, grades, assessment scores, as well as update their students' contact information. On the next slide, you will see a table of contents for the video that shows areas of focus and the mark time that corresponds to them within the video. Feel free to pause or fast forward if you want to view specific portions of this video. You will also see blurred images throughout the video. This is to protect the student's identity that is being used for this demonstration. You can access the PowerSchool Parent Portal a couple of ways. You can type the web address into the web browser URL address field using gcsnc.powerschool.com/public, or go to the Guilford County Schools homepage at www.gcsnc.com. Scroll down the page until you see the PowerSchool Parent and Student Portal icon. Click on the icon. The icon will take you to the Guilford Parent Academy website. From there, you will click on the link titled Login to the PowerSchool Parent Portal. Once the PowerSchool Parent Portal sign-in screen appears, enter the username and password you created for your account and click Sign In. The PowerSchool logo located here in the top left-hand corner can be used to return to your default homepage at any time. On the right-hand side of the screen, you have several helpful links. The Help link can be used to access the PowerSchool Parent Portal online help feature. The sitemap link will take you to a more detailed listing of what can be viewed from certain menu items. The sign-out link will be used when you are ready to sign out of the system. We suggest you always sign out each time you are through reviewing your Parent Portal account. The menu toolbar is the dark blue bar that runs across the top of the screen located directly under the PowerSchool logo. The tab or tabs at the front of the toolbar identify the student or students who are associated with your PowerSchool Parent Portal account. Clicking on the name will take you to the information associated with the specified student. If you find that you are missing a student on your account, no worries, we will show you how to add them later. On the right side of the menu toolbar is an icon that looks like a box with an arrow coming from it. This is the application link. The application link can be used to navigate to additional applications currently being used in Guilford County Schools. There are two application links. The first is called the Digital Document Delivery. This link does not display any data. Any documents received through Digital Document Delivery will be emailed to you. Documents such as middle and high school report cards, district surveys, etc. The second link is called Document Management. This link also does not display any data. The next icon in the menu toolbar is an exclamation mark. This icon shares security information such as the last login date and time, as well as any failed login attempts since your last login. The last icon in the menu toolbar is the printer icon. Clicking on the printer icon will provide you with a printer-friendly version of the screen you are currently viewing. Additionally, the page includes the name of the selected student. Now, let's talk about the navigation menu found on the left-hand side of the screen. Let's explore and see just how much information the PowerSchool Parent Portal can provide. The first tab is called Grades and Attendance. This screen can be used to review your students' current grades and attendance, which is in real time. At the bottom of the screen, there is a link titled Show Drop Classes Also. You can click on this link to show dropped courses if your child has any. If you don't want to display dropped courses, simply click on the Show Only Current Classes to return to the previous listing of current classes. The dark blue links, email addresses, attendance counts, and grades are hyperlinks and will navigate you to additional information. Let's give it a try. If you click on a grade under the current quarter, you are redirected to an individual assignment list and the associated grades used to calculate the quarter grade. Notice on the screen, you also see different icons that mean things such as missing and late. A legend for the icons can be found at the bottom of the screen. Also at the bottom of the assignments, you can see the last date the grades were updated. To return to the previous screen, click on the grades and attendance icon. Next, click on a number under the absence or tardy column. You are redirected to a list of the actual absence or tardy dates and the corresponding absence code being assigned to that day. To return to the previous screen, click on the grades and attendance icon. The final hyperlink is the email address located under the course name. This link will open a new email box to allow you to email the teacher of the course directly. However, this only works if you have an email account on the device you are using. From here, we will move to our next icon, test results. Currently, this icon is not being used in North Carolina. Next up, we have grade history. Click here to view students' grades for the current and previous academic years. Click each tab within grade history to view grades achieved during that school year. The grades are separated by each grading term. You have quarter grades represented by a Q and used at all school levels. The semester grades are represented by an S and are for year-long courses at the middle and high school level. Final grades are represented with an F and are for all courses at the middle and high school level. The grades represented with an A are used to calculate athletic eligibility in high school. The next link is called State Test Reports. And this provides you with an informative hyperlink about North Carolina individual student reports and the end of the year testing scores for your child. Next, we have email notifications. I have a feeling you are going to like this. Email notifications has three separate tabs. The first one is called General Notification. This tab allows you to request certain reports automatically. Reports such as summary of current grades and attendance, detailed report showing assignment scores for each class, detailed reports of attendance, school announcements, and balance alert. However, Guilford County Schools does not currently use the balance alerts. The additional notification email section should be used to add additional email addresses of those that you would like to receive the same notifications, such as your spouse. You will enter the email address and use a comma to separate it if you have more than one. Under the frequency section, you can choose the frequency in which you receive the selected notifications. How often? Your options are never, weekly, every 2 weeks, monthly, and daily. The system defaults to never. Apply these settings to all of your students. By clicking this box, you are instructing the system to send the selected notifications for all of the students in your account using the selected frequency. Send now for the student listed. By clicking this box, this will send the information for the selected student only. Don't forget to hit the submit button after completing your selections. The submit button is in the bottom right-hand corner of the screen. The second tab is called Document Library. which does not currently populate any data. The final tab is Document Delivery. This screen is set up at the school level to ensure you and your child receive any documents sent out via email. All documents are password protected with a pre-assigned password, which is the last four digits of your child's lunch number. If you do not want to receive email documents, you can opt out by removing the Check In the Opt-in box. Feel free to add any additional email addresses, but please leave the student email address. If you decide to change the password, it should be a four-digit number. Don't forget to write it down. In the event you do forget your password, you will need to contact the data manager at your child's school to reset it for you. Let them know that you need your document delivery password reset. The next tab is called Document Library. As mentioned before, this link currently does not display any data. The next link is Teacher Comments. This link can be used to view any comments a teacher may have entered at the end of the reporting term. You can use the Reporting Term drop-down menu to change the term. The screen also contains the email hyperlinks like the grades and attendance screen, as well as show dropped courses for the selected reporting term. The Forms link displays a variety of forms which should be completed as needed, or at least the beginning of each school year. In the far right-hand corner of the screen, you can select to update your form settings by clicking on the cog wheel. This will allow you to add an email address to receive notifications of new forms or changes to your form. This screen has four different tabs. The first one is called General Forms, and these are forms shared with you from the school level. By completing these forms, your child's PowerSchool information will be updated at the school. Class Forms. These are forms that have been created by the teachers for you to complete. All Forms is a combination of both general and class forms. And finally, Student Support. These are individualized student support forms. To complete a form, you will click on the blue hyperlink for each form and fill it out. The screen will display the status of the form next to it. The status will be not started, submitted, pending, approved, or rejected. For more information on completing forms, feel free to watch our Parent Portal Forms video. The next link is called My Schedule, and this provides you with a listing of your student's schedule, including teacher name. There are three tabs on this screen. The first one is called Current Year Schedule, which displays your student's schedule for the current year. Weekly Schedule displays the schedule for the week, including times. And finally, Matrix Schedule, which displays the schedule for each day. If your student has an A, B day course, meaning they meet in the course on alternating days, this will help you determine which day they are meeting. The school information link gives you the contact information for your student's school, address, phone numbers, principal, assistant principal, and the terms. The school bulletin link displays any news posted by the district or your student school. Transportation information displays the bus number, pickup location, and time for your student's morning and afternoon bus schedule. This is a great place to look when you are waiting on a bus assignment. Next, we have account preferences. There are two tabs on this screen. The Profile tab allows you to update your account email, change your language options, edit your username, and update your password. To change the account email, just update the email in the account email box. To update your language option, choose a language from the Select Language drop-down menu. To change your username, click on the pencil icon next to the username. And finally, to change your password, click on the same pencil icon next to the current password box. Be sure to follow the password rules. The password must be at least 8 characters long, must contain at least one uppercase and one lowercase letter, must contain at least one number, contains at least one special character, such as an exclamation mark, hashtag, or dollar sign, to name a few. Once you have completed any changes, always remember to select Save in the bottom right-hand corner of the screen. The Save and Cancel button will appear grayed out if no changes are made. The second tab is the Students tab. This tab should be used to add any additional students. When adding a student, you must have the student's access ID and access password, and you can get this information from the data manager at your student school. To add a student, click on the Add link in the top right-hand corner of the section. Enter the student's name, access ID, and access password. The access ID and access passwords are case sensitive. Enter them exactly as they appear on the email or document. Once all three fields have been populated, click OK. Your student will appear in the list in the My Students section. However, you will have to log out and back into the system in order for the new student to show up on the menu toolbar. The North Carolina Options link contains the Family Educational Rights and Privacy Act, also known as FERPA, as well as the annual opt-out options form. This form should be updated yearly. And please read the questions and select the appropriate answer for you and your student. The last link is called the Digital Survey link. This link displays the Out-of-School Digital Device Access Survey. The state is collecting this information to help target areas where adequate internet access is not available. The information gathered will be kept private and confidential. Now you know how to navigate your PowerSchool Parent Portal account. Thank you for choosing Guilford County Schools, where we are better together.